One thing that's become clear during the pandemic is how much of our medical supplies and prescriptions come from China. Could lead to dangerous shortages if production stops or if China withholds its goods in a time of crisis.
New legislation from Wisconsin Congressman Mike Gallagher and Senator Tom Cotton would incentivize more U.S. drug production and create more transparency around country of origin. They also want to block the federal government from purchasing Chinese pharmaceutical goods. Joining us now via Skype to elaborate on this and talk about the coronavirus response in general is Wisconsin Congressman Mike Gallagher. Thank you for joining us, Congressman. Great to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Of course, sir.
Could you just lay out what you're hoping to accomplish with this bill alongside Senator Cotton?
Well, as we are learning painfully in this crisis, today most active pharmaceutical ingredients, or APIs, used for drugs in the United States are actually made in China. And it's not just exotic or esoteric drugs. This includes 95% of our imports of ibuprofen, 40 to 45% of penicillin. And as we've seen throughout the coronavirus crisis, this was a huge mistake. It creates a dangerous dependency. And when you have Chinese Communist Party officials threatening to cut off exports and plunge the United States into an ocean of coronavirus, to coin their phrase, I think we need to look at how we reduce that vulnerability and start shifting our supply chain in the future so that we don't find ourselves in a similar situation. Mm-hmm. So what Senator Cotton and myself are trying to do in this bill is to require the FDA to track APIs and tell us if indeed there is a dependency on a foreign country, prohibit purchases from China for HHS, VA, DOD, et cetera, and then over time incentivize the private sector to bring that manufacturing back to the U.S. by allowing immediate expensing for firms that incur costs associated with rebalancing their supply chain.
Mm-hmm. I mean, it seems like absolute common sense to me, sir. And yet we see there are several free market groups that are out there saying that this would hurt the American supply chain, that any sort of Buy American order put forward by the president or legislation type yours would inhibit their ability in order to keep costs down. What's your response to them, who are saying that, you know, it's more efficient to do it this way?
Well, efficiency, I think, needs to be balanced against survival. What is the cost right now of the coronavirus crisis? I think it's fair to say that had we invested a smaller amount in things like testing, in things like domestic manufacturing, not only of pharmaceuticals, but of basic medical supplies, we wouldn't be paying trillions upon trillions of dollars to get ourselves out of this mess. And so a short-term efficiency might lead to a long-term loss. Certainly there will be costs associated with changing supply chains, but that's why we have a waiver for 2 years, and then over the course of 4 years, allow businesses to get a tax incentive for rebalancing their supply chain. But I just would say we have to look industry by industry, because it's not just the pharmaceutical industry, it extends into the telecommunications industry, and ask ourselves this very hard question. Do we want to be dependent on the largesse of the Chinese Communist Party in future crises? And for me, the answer to that is no. And in order to prevent that from happening, I am willing to pay a substantial price.
Mm-hmm. Congressman, I think that's well said. I mean, my question is really, do you think incentivizing companies to do the right thing is enough when you're talking about these essential critical supplies? Do you think the federal government needs to take an even heavier handed approach?
Well, the short answer is we don't know. Senator Cotton and myself have put forward a very aggressive timeline, 2024. You could sort of think about this as Made in America 2024 to contrast with the Made in China 2025 project. But we'll see how successful that timeline is and how successful the mechanisms we have, a mix of incentives and sticks, carrots and sticks. In other words, we're prohibiting certain purchases, is. I do think, however, given the corruption of the Chinese Communist Party, given the dangerous dependency they've induced not only here but around the world, there are a lot of companies that are looking over the long term and rethinking whether it's a good idea to concentrate so much of their manufacturing in China. I would hope that there's a lot of people in the tech industry as well that are realizing that doing business with China in the short term creates long-term vulnerabilities. But we'll see. This will be the project of at least a decade, figuring out how we responsibly decouple key parts of our economy from that of China's.
Mm-hmm. Congressman, we also wanted to ask you just for an update on how you think the crisis is going, especially in your home state of Wisconsin. I know you'd asked for some more FEMA resources and other that. Just give us an update on how your district, your state, and how the overall response is going, in your opinion.
Well, we still aren't where we need to be in terms of testing. We have, you know, it's interesting. There's a similar story playing out in testing. We've discovered single points of failure in our testing supply chain. For example, as our hospitals here in Wisconsin are starting to ramp up their ability to do drive-through tests, we're discovering we can't process those tests because we lack things like reagent, which is something you need to process the test, and basic swabs. So these are things we should be producing domestically, and that's why we are not able to ramp testing up sort of along the South Korean model right now. Improvements are being made. Everyone is mobilizing. You know, America tends to be slow at the early stages of a crisis, but then the entire society mobilizes. So I believe we are headed in the right direction, and though it's not happening as fast as I'd like, I am confident that when the dust settles, we will have figured this thing out.
Mm-hmm. Congressman, have you seen any bipartisan interest from your Democratic colleagues on the legislation you and Senator Cotton are working on?
Well, so far, I don't think we have any Democratic co-sponsors. However, we, on similar legislation in the telecom space, legislation designed to block CCP-controlled companies like Huawei and ZTE from controlling the future of the internet, every single bill I've introduced has been a bipartisan bill. I do think there is a lot of bipartisan interest along this issue. The idea of producing things domestically, strengthening our supply chain, enhancing American manufacturing, I think is an idea that gets a lot of Republicans and Democrats talking together. So I think shortly, here soon, we will have Democratic co-sponsors.
Well, we certainly hope so, and we'll be pushing forward here on this show. Thank you, Congressman, for joining us. We really appreciate it.
Thanks, Congressman. Stay well.
Thank you.
Of course. Next on Rising, could moving towards a progressive ideals benefit the economy in a time of crisis? Professor Harvey J.K., he makes that case when Rising continues.